Alcohol manufacturers have weighed in on the proposed Alcoholic Drinks Control Bill 2022, saying it infringes on consumer rights. Manufacturers, including Uganda Breweries Limited and Nile Breweries under their umbrella body, Uganda Alcohol Industry Association, are hesitant to support the bill that seeks to regulate the manufacture, importation, sale and consumption of alcohol. This was during a stakeholder engagement organized by Parliament.
It's not availability, but it's abuse. It's like even non-alcoholic products. We are all worried about obesity. Is it alcohol causing it? We are worried about a lot of other things. So isolating alcohol, stigmatizing it as the only abused substance which needs to be controlled, we feel it's an overreach.
Led by Onapito Ekomoloit, the chairperson of the association, alcoholic drinks manufacturers submitted that the bill is against fundamental freedoms, including the freedom to consumer choice, freedom of access to goods and services, freedom of trade, and freedom of employment.
This bill actually is regressive. It is not in conformity with what the NRM has championed for the last 37 years. Freedoms and rights.
The bill proposes a fine of 20 million shillings or imprisonment of 10 years to whoever is found guilty of selling alcohol during prohibited hours. The association submitted that there is no evidence that alcohol abuse only takes place during morning hours.
Drinking in the morning the wrong way is abuse. Drinking in the morning the right way is not abuse. Drinking in the evening at the 6, the wrong way is abuse. Drinking the right way is not abuse. So it is not the hour, it is the person's behavior.
The association is also against licensing of alcoholic drink sales, saying it will kick the small-scale retailers out of business. The bill provides for provision of a license valid for 12 months.
There should be no requirement for special licenses for selling alcohol, because I said earlier, it undermines small traders, single mamas. It is counterproductive for free enterprise. Let people get a generic license. It is working in Uganda today.
The alcohol industry contributes 4.9% of Uganda's GDP. Manufacturers of alcoholic drinks believe legislations of this kind will choke growth of the industry.
Those who are licensed and pay tax and are registered at Uganda National Bureau of Standards, we are contributing 4.9% of the GDP. In simple terms, that means we are paying above 1 trillion shillings in tax. That is the industry as it stands. Employing people across board, and not just people at Uganda Breweries and Nile Breweries who are making the beer. When I say employment, I'm talking the entire value chain.
However, MP Sarah Opendi, who proposed the bill, assured the industry that the bill was brought in good faith with the view of eliminating illicit trade, protect children, and provide for rehabilitation programs.
It's my request that you support this bill, because what we need is to see alcohol produced in this country by licensed producers. And when you're a licensed producer, issues of safety are taken into consideration. Currently, as we speak, we have alcohol out there on the market that is produced by unlicensed people.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.